Christ. As we rejoice in his coming, we light this evening the Advent wreath, the Christ candle, candle there in the center, knowing that Christ is our hope, he's our peace. In him is love, pure, holy, undying love. Whoever believes in him, the Bible says in John 3:16, will never perish but have everlasting life. Thanks be to God, Paul tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, for his indescribable.
Thank you. Christmas season. Isaiah 9:2. The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light. If they dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shine. Isaiah 9:6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Luke 2:1-5. And it came to pass in those days there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrus reigned, the government of Syria, and all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, of the house and lineage of David. To be taxed with Mary, his spouse, wife, being great with child. And so it was, all they were there, the days were accomplished, that she should be delivered. And she brought forth his firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of God shone around about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, but behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And it shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find in the babe swaddling clothes lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel all the view of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth, goodwill toward men. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they seen it, they made known abroad the thing which was told them concerning the shadow. And they heard it wondered at the thing which was told them by the shepherds. Matthew 2:1-2. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east of Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born, King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and we are come to worship him. And when they were come into the house, they saw a young child with Mary and his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned glorifying and praising God for all the things they had learned or heard and seen, as it was told unto them. as time passed, Mary and Joseph passed away.
In John chapter 1, as we focus our time this evening on just that thought on the light, I just want to share with you a couple of things as we think about that. And as we just kind of meditate, if you will, on the fact that Jesus is our light, amen? Okay? In John chapter 1, beginning in verse 1, it says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was And the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not." You know, as we think about that word light, I just want to share a story with you. Several years ago, and I'm talking several years ago, I was probably Hayden's age. I hadn't had my license very long, and my brothers decided to take a road trip. And they let a little brother go along. And we were going to Savannah. If you know anything about my brothers, they were in a sandwich steamer franchise for several years. And we were going to Savannah to pick up two gently used, worn-out trucks. and so we go down there, and on the way down, we are going through, going down the turnpike down through Virginia, and it's dark. And we're driving along, and we know where we're at. We've been down this way numerous times. Nothing far away. We're coming over the mountains, and just kind of, you look out, and as far as you can see, it was lit up. And as dark as it was, and as many lights as there were out there, you know, when they talk about, in Matthew chapter 5, a city on a hill cannot be hidden, that valley couldn't be hidden. The lights over there. And one of the brothers, I don't know which one it was, made the remark of, when we come back through, I'm going to find out what city that was. We come back through, and it's Heartland. There wasn't even a city there. It was just the lights of the farms. And every time we do a Christmas Eve service, if you think about that light, I think about that trip. And the thing I think about that trip is the light.
Now, we looked over there and all we saw were lies. As we think about that this evening, and when people look at our lives, do we reflect that light? We talk about the Bethlehem Star. I don't know if you've been able to see it or not. Dave asked me earlier. I did. Felt like you're driving through the mountains. We were in Gallenberg the last couple of days. She said, "Well, you're driving through the mountains to see the star." Didn't think about that. Maybe we should have. And when we think about that, and we think about that star, and you think about those lights following a strange light. They'd never seen it before. But their curiosity got the best of them. And what they did, they followed the star. You know, as I think about that, I think about the light that we are to shine before men, Jesus tells me in Matthew chapter 5, down the Sermon on the Mount. Are people following the light that we are reflecting? Whose light are we reflecting? Jesus. The light that came into darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. I'm thankful this evening as we contemplate the light that was given, the gift that was given. I'm thankful for the light. I'm thankful for what it represents in our life. And even in the darkest of days, and we've had a few of those in 2020, there's still light. And that light is the light of men. He said, "I am the light." Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you this evening for your love and mercy. We thank you for the grace that keeps us and sustains us. Dear Heavenly Father, we're thankful as we sing this evening. Lord, as we look at the Christmas story through candlelight, Lord, we're reminded of who you are. And Lord, as we look at the table before us, Mary and Joseph's candles are out. The shepherd's candles are out. Even the angels returned back home. The wise men returned back to their homeland. But Lord, that light that was shining 2,000 years ago is still shining in our hearts tonight. And Lord, we thank you for the light. We thank you for the light that exposes darkness, Lord. Causes us to grieve our sin, and Lord, causes us to desire a deeper, greater relationship with you. Lord, may our light so shine before men that they may see our good works and glorify our Father, which is in heaven. And Lord, may our light point people to you, the source of the light. We thank you for all these things. Amen.
Now, it wouldn't be a candlelight service unless, and this is my favorite part of this service, because we take one light, we light it off to Christ. And I told Charlene it works just like the gospel. One candle's lit. It does kind of look like it's about a candle bulb there, aren't I? But one candle is lit, and what do we do with that candle? What do we do with that light? Hey, sometimes we've got to light it twice. Sometimes you have to rededicate your life.
Thank you. reasonable work for him.
Father, how we thank you for the service that we've all experienced this evening. It's something special, unique, and different. It's our way of celebrating the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and all the things for him. Father, we ask that forever we let our light shine, that others may see you through us, come to know you, and therefore. Now that we come to the close of this first word, we ask that you give us our verses and grace of all. To bring us back to the next appointed time. Lead us, guide us, and direct us in everything we say and do. With all of us, bring great honor and glory to your name. Do you think we ask in Jesus' name and for this day? Amen.
Love you. God bless you. From our house to yours, have a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah.